When compositing effects, lighting can be key to get it to look just right. With our EXR files, you're given full customization by getting access to multiple lighting passes like key, fill, rim, fire, and more. In this video, I'm going to show you how to properly set up and use your EXR file inside of DaVinci Resolve so that you get the most out of your ActionVFX asset. Now, here we are in Resolve. So we have one of the directional explosions. To split out the channels for the first step, you can either copy and paste the input and change your layer selection right here to your layer. Or if you're using a newer version of Resolve, you can use their new node called the Whistler, and you can separate the channels out that way. So I'm going to do that. All you do is bring your input in, and then in your source layer, you select the render pass that you want. So I'll select our key, copy and paste, and we'll do our fill, our rim, and our explosion light. So now we have each of our render passes available to us separately. Next, we will do an alpha divide, which is just like the unpremultiply. So alpha divide, and this will unpremultiply our image. You can see the edges change. Throw one of those on each of our render passes. All right, next we will merge our render passes together. So to do that, we're going to be using the channel boolean. And we'll do our first pass and our second pass. And then here in the operation, we're going to do add. And then alpha, we're going to set to do nothing. This means that it'll just ignore the alpha channel and add all the RGB values together. So we go from just having our key to having our key and our fill in the same image added together. And we'll do a similar thing as before, where we will copy and paste and bring in our third light layer. Now we have our rim light mixed in. And lastly, we'll bring in our fire. So now we have that full image. And we can do a final merge, which will copy our alpha channel back in and pre-multiply. And we'll bring in our final image here. And then our second input is our original footage. So what this will do is allow us to set the apply mode. This will allow us to set the operator to mask. And that's going to apply our alpha channel to our final image, which we then can go in and look at it over our background just like this. So with this, we've now pre-multiplied our alpha that we had divided, and this gives us our proper edges. So now we can add any sort of color correction that we want to add. Color corrector node after each one of my render passes so that we could, for instance, with the fire, we can bring down the gate. We can also increase the fill light, or we can even tint it. So if we want a more dusty sand look, we can easily make that happen to make it match our plate better. And that's how you set up our multi-channel EXR files. Let us know in the comments down below what tutorial you'd like to see next. Don't forget to head on over to actionvfx.com, where you can browse the world's largest library of 2D and 3D assets ready for film, games, and television. With that said, get out there and start creating, and I'll see you on the next one.